edition, and to kick off the ESPY Awards, there's a big event here with celebrities, athletes, and much more. Check out behind me is the grotto, there's a silent auction, and very soon the party here will be popping.
Oh man, I hope it's not too many.
Kevin Durant, first thing that comes to mind.
Superstar.
Russell Westbrook.
Smooth.
Smooth. How about Oklahoma City?
Great.
Thunder.
Lovely.
Lovely. If Russell Westbrook wasn't an NBA star, he would be?
In school.
In school doing what major?
African-American studies.
Really? Yeah. You want to be a professor one day?
Huh?
Would you like to be a PhD? Like?
No. I can't go that far. I'll just, you know, take my classes and then see what happens after that.
There are tons of stars here today. What's your favorite sport away from basketball?
Football.
Really? You look like you could play.
I used to be able to play in my young days.
And now it's like, nah, too much on the line.
In my young days.
Perfect. Thank you very much. Yep. Hope it was great seeing you.
Yes, sir.
So let's get you to it.
Hey, what do you think about Amir Johnson?
Congratulations for my man Amir.
Why? He got married?
Nah, he'll tell you.
Okay.
He'll tell you.
Everyone knows him now. Made it to the playoffs, played against the Lakers, and gave them a hell of a run. How was that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Hey, Cleveland needs all the support they can get, so that's why I have it on. No further questions, Allie.
Hey, I just came back from NY.
Oh, yeah.
If they see LeBron, you're going to watch out. Not very popular.
Right.
I'm here.
Yo,
how are you?
What's going on,
man? Nice to see you.
What's up?
OCTV.
All right.
So, tell us what's happening. Why are you here tonight?
You know, it's my first time here. I kind of wanted to see what it was like. You know, I know it's for the guys, man. Check out beautiful women and.
Up, I'm good. How are you?
Been at, man?
Working.
Working.
You see the video I did from the other event?
Yeah, that was nice. It was pretty funny, man.
Hey, that's how we do it. Yes, 3, 2, 1. I'm here with NBA star Amir Johnson, and he has an exclusive, huge announcement to tell you guys.
You crazy? What announcement I gotta tell you?
Russell told me you have a big announcement.
Russell was just messing with you, man. Why are you listening to him? Like, he was just playing with you. I ain't got no big announcement, man.
Why do people say congratulations to you?
Oh, you talking about my re-sign? That was old. That was old news.
So why are people acting like you're LeBron who just signed with Miami?
Ain't nobody acting like I'm LeBron, man.
I got to ask you this.
Why are you playing with me, man? We out here trying to have a good time. We at the Playboy Mansion. Why can't you ask me no questions like that?
Okay, we're at the Playboy Mansion, and you're an NBA star, so a lot of girls will be hitting on you. What's the best pickup line you ever heard?
The best pickup line I ever heard. I don't really have one, you know what I mean? I don't. I'm not no player. I'm kind of quiet type. I just kind of walk in. I think I sell them with my smile. That's what does it for me.
I got to ask, you came here flossing today, the watch. You got to tell us about that watch.
Show
it to the camera.
This is a little watch I had, you know what I mean? It's not too much. No, I'm not that flossy. It's a little Jacob I got. It's all black diamonds. I ain't going to tell you the price, but it was expensive.
You travel a lot. Do people ever confuse you with other NBA stars like they think you're someone else?
You know that. You seen my YouTube, but people mistake me sometimes for Andre 3000. People that don't watch basketball say I kind of look like Andre 3000. So, of course, if you go on my YouTube called Amir TV, you can see me doing a little spoof of me acting like Andre 3000.
So what have you been up to all summer? Last time we talked, you were just getting off the season, and now we're like well into it.
Well, you know that I re-signed, you know, to Toronto.
It's huge. Fans love you out there. They go crazy.
So I'm going to be out there for the next 5 years playing out in Toronto. You know, and all I've been doing is really working out, working on my game, you know, and just trying to step up and be that player. You know, I got goals I need to set. You know, and one of them is to jump on Shaq, just to put that in there. That's one of my goals, and it might probably be an all-star, so I'm just working on my game.
Jared Jack, what do you think about it?
He's a great guy, funny, and he's a leader.
How about number 10?
Number 10? What's that? What you talking about? DeMar?
DeMar DeRozan, the human highlight film.
He's a great young player, man. I think with a lot of work, he works hard, though, but with a little bit of work, you know, he can be something great.
What do you think about Clarence?
Clarence, you know by his real name. How do you know his real name?
Hey, I have contacts. People call me and say, hey, ask about that. You're a clown. Jared Jack told me. He said, Elie, ask about Clarence.
I know he's going to hate that.
Yeah, he does.
Clarence, man, he's a great player. You know, he's a terrific scorer already, you know, and he's a great athlete. You know, I think he's a great addition to our team. You know, we're going to be something fun. You know, they're already in Toronto. They're calling us the young guns right now. So,
they said,
with us three, yeah.
DeMar DeRozan told me he wants you guys to be the Oklahoma City of the East.
Okay. Better than that. You know, I mean, we're gonna be something better than that. So hopefully we can do that. You know, they're starting to call us the young guns because we're so athletic and we run the floor. So we kind of sticking to that name right now.
How relieved are you to get 5 more years, to have a direction, to know you have a home now instead of like bouncing?
You know, it's kind of like a lot of weight off my back, and I know I'm gonna be somewhere. That's great, and I know the city loves me, and so, you know, I'm happy.
Two more questions. I know the fans over there love you. Tell me about that. What kind of response do you get from the fans when you go places?
The fans really kind of made me let me settle my final decision about staying in Toronto, because I know how much support they were giving me. You know, I was getting a lot of feedback on Twitter, you know what I mean, just knowing my style of play, which is I hustle and do all the little stuff. So, you know, I love it there, and they love me, I love them.
What's your nickname?
My nickname is AJ, for sure. That's what they.
So this you, is this
what, what's my nickname?
We gotta come up with a cool nickname. If you're a fan in Toronto, hit him up on Twitter, and he's gonna pick the best name and stick with it all year. Does that work, Amir?
That's a bet right there. I like that.
That's a bet, and you can come up with anything crazy. The crazier, the better. Great seeing you.
Yes,
what do you say about LeBron in Miami?
That's gonna be a hell of a squad. You know what I mean? I know a lot of teams are gonna be going for their head though, because since they want to team up together, so you know we definitely gonna play hard against Miami.
Have you ever posterized LeBron?
I think I might have caught him. Kind of, you know how he trails the play. I think I might have. I didn't kind of body to body, but he tried to block my shot. He didn't really get it.
So there you have it, basketball superstar Amir Johnson. He's gonna be in Toronto for 5 more years. So get used to it. From the Playboy Mansion, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. All right, I'm gonna go get some dates. But Amir signing in Toronto for 5 more years.
It's overdue. Long overdue. He's the greatest player ever.
No, but a lot of fans haven't seen him go to his full potential yet. He's an amazing player, but he needs time. You need to play to introduce him.
Yeah, you know, he's averaged like 6 points last year in 15 minutes. So, you know, if he gets the time, I feel like he'll be able to have a double-double, you know. And he just needs the minutes, basically.
What your fans know about him away from basketball?
Amir's crazy, you know. He's always laughing and telling jokes, so that's why I got the Amir TV channel to kind of show us rapping and the stuff he does, singing and imitating people and stuff
like that.
Westchester
High School, yeah. Legendary school, producing more NBA players than anyone.
Right.
Does he stay in touch with the fellas?
Yeah. You know, he still talks to Trevor,
Gabe
Hassan, Gabe, yeah. We know all of them, so.
It's a crazy school.
Shout out to GP.
There?
Yeah, I went there.
How crazy was that school?
It was good, man. We had good times. You know, everybody grew up together. All went to Overite Middle School, then went to Westchester. So.
Did you know Oki Agoki?
No, I don't know him.
Jermaine Chase? They're a little older.
No, they're older. Yeah, we got there like in 2000. So anybody like under 2000, like Brandon Granville, Tony Bland, like those cats, we know.
Yeah. Amir on the court, 1-1 against LeBron. Who wins?
AJ.
our win at the 2010 Broom Cup.
Oh, my.
All right.
One more interview.
Okay, well,
yes.
Wants to ask you a couple quick questions.
Okay.
How are you doing? It's been a couple months since we've seen you guys.
Yeah.
So, when's the last time you brushed your teeth today?
Right before I came, I took a shower.
Yeah,
took a shower. The water in my house has no warm water. So I'm quick in it.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. That's not my in my house. I got a nice stream, a nice flow. Boom, boom, boom. So I actually did it right before we left as well. I will say that I don't usually brush my teeth in the middle of the day. I don't like the taste.
So we're going for like 2 times?
Two times.
What do you mean you don't brush your teeth?
No.
I'll go buy you a toothbrush.
You can buy me a toothbrush. You can buy me the little
the floss,
the floss swords. You can buy all that shit. I have, you know, whoopee to make with these groupies. I got things to do. I can't just brush my teeth all day. You know?
Okay, idea. So let me ask this. Serious question. If you guys would you rather be the sickest rapper or the sickest dancer?
Can I be the sickest dance rapper or rap dancer? I take woo! that's a good question. Because, yeah, oh,
that's easy. Oh, that's, yeah, that's true.
Yeah, all that. I have to say rapper, because that's our roots.
Yeah.
That's our roots, is rapper.
I have to say rapper. And then you just hired a sixth dancer.
Yeah.
Because you're going to make more money than a sixth dancer than a rapper.
Yeah.
What's really
good? I mean, Fred Astaire is the last dancer that really, you know.
What, not now?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm going to get Neo.
Love you guys. We'll see you again soon.
I got to tell you, you remind me of Sideshow Bob and you remind me of Weird Al. You ever get that?
No, man, that's the first time.
What did you hear about that?
I'm just playing.
Nah, that's you know, first of all, I'm getting rights for the Sideshow Bob character. I licensed my image. That's A. And Weird Al Yankovic.
I'm going to be like an alter ego, Weird Al Yankovic. That's me.
Okay? So.
Quick question. Yeah. You guys are here to kick off the ESPY Awards. So if you were to win an award, what kind of sport, what athlete would you be?
What we want.
That's good,
that's
man.
That's a good tie-in.
Yeah.
Because we did win an award.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. We're the Broom Cup champions, if you've noticed.
Right.
It's a curling. The broom. Everybody's familiar with the Broom Cup.
The Broom Cup?
Yeah. I mean, it's in the summer every year. It's the curling.
Come on.
The throwing the rock, the sweeping.
I really got to get up to date with my curling awards.
Yeah, YouTube it. But this year, we're the winners. It's not televised. I think that's the problem.
Oh,
and we
it.
And we snuck a camera in, and we're going to play it tonight. We're going to play the
pay-per-view.
Did you pay to get in here? Well, then it's free for you.
It's free for you.
It's free for you.
Yeah.
Looking forward to it.
Yeah.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
What's the deal with the outfits, though?
Well, you know, the outfits is something that champions just, you know, they do. This is the party rock line.
Yes.
You know, a lot of people. We have our designers here. You know, sitting in the booth, and
we gotta roll to the next. It's tighter than skin and bologna.
Well, you know.
The thing is, you just gotta show off what you got.
It's hard.
Go to next.
We gotta go.
Hey guys,
love y'all.
Right here.
Last okay.
Hey guys.
Hey,
hi guys. Really? How are you?
Just can you spell your sister last name?
S A B R I N A. Are you recording right now? S A B R I N A B A R N E T T. Sabrina Barnett.
So tell me about this event. How did you put it all together? It's athletes, actors.
Well, I believe in unity. We have a clothing line called Let Your Love Shine, one shirt at a time. It's all about, you know, getting together, being one person, one people. So we've designed a shirt for men, and it's a woman's empowerment line, but we really want to get everybody together here, so we decided to come to the Playboy Mansion and just have everybody rock out and have a great time. Proceeds are going to a lot of different charities. We're working with different charities, probably right now about 6 or 7. Warren Moon is a big fan. I really love him very much. I think he's an awesome man. And Dave Meltzer. So really it's because of them that we've come together tonight to really reunite everybody.
What's your favorite sport and who's your favorite athlete?
Oh, God, I don't have any favorites. I love everybody.
Thank you.
When I say we, I mean the USA, but it would have been great. Pardon me? November 13th. Maybe.
Break it down.
Maybe November 13th. Break it down. Just as long as they fight, and you know, I get to be there. That's the best thing right now. Hoping for it.
Who are some of your favorite fighters all time?
All time? Muhammad Ali. When I was in junior high, I loved Floyd Patterson. And my all-time favorite, I happened to catch the end of his career, would be Sugar Ray Robinson.
Do you ever train in the gym? Do you ever go hit the bag?
When I was in the Army, I tried boxing. You know, we used to, you know, wear headgear and all that. And there was just one problem. I hated that rule where the other guy's allowed to hit you back. Hated that part.
Because so many times, like members of the media, other people around the sport never practiced and never tasted it. So you're in it and you also experienced it. So does that help you in the ring?
You know, I'm just a big fan, so I just love what I do, and I'm right there in the middle of it and get to introduce those guys. And a lot of times I'm pulling for both guys, and I hope nobody gets hurt. And while you enjoy the victory, the agony of defeat is also there with me, too.
Why do people love boxing so much, in your opinion?
It's mano a mano. It's, you know, basically when the bell rings, all the training is behind you, and you have to perform.
Last question. If you could have picked another career, what would Michael Buffer be today?
Well, I tried being a car salesman, but I was pretty bad at that, you know, 30 years ago. So
that's it.
That's it, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Thanks for your time.
Thanks.
2-1. So, Ty, we're here at the Playboy Mansion, but we're not going to talk about that. We're talking about the Klitschkos. What's up with them? What's next?
Well, we just won the purse bid for Vladimir's fight against Alexander Povetkin. Povetkin's a great challenger. He's the number one contender, mandatory for the IBF. He's undefeated. He's an Olympic gold medalist. So, really looking forward to that fight. That one's going to be September 11th in Frankfurt at the Commerzbank Arena. It's going to be over 50,000 people again, which are huge events over in Europe.
Are they like the Pacquiao's of Germany? Like, do people go crazy for them, the followers, the TV, the everything?
Well, the funny thing is Pacquiao fought one time in a big arena. He did well. I think he had about 55,000 people there, and Arum did a great job. Top Rank did a great job promoting that fight. This would be the third time that Vladimir's fought in a big soccer stadium, 60,000 seats or 50,000 seats. So this has become a regular for the brothers. Vitaly just fought in a soccer stadium in his last fight against Sosnowski, who was a European champion. So this has become, you know, the Klitschkos have really outgrown the arenas in Germany, and now we've got to put them in soccer stadiums. And it's really a big event. RTL does a fantastic job of promoting the fight as far as doing all the production and the entrances and making it really a great event. And that's really our hope, our main TV sponsor over there in Germany. And, you know, we're looking to keep them active, and the way they fight and train and focus on the sport, I don't see anyone beating either Vitaly or Vladimir anytime soon.
Vlad against David Haye, would that ever happen, or is that like one of those?
Well,
we're working on it.
That question is not for our side. I know Vladimir's made him a very generous offer, made him a 50-50 deal. My understanding is Haye still has some options that he has to deal with Sauerland. And he wants to probably get this other fight with Audley Harrison in to make some money. And then, you know, hopefully in the future after that, we can put that fight together for either Vladimir or Vitaly. I hear different excuses that they don't want to fight Vladimir first, they want to fight Vitaly first, or whatever it is. But, I mean, that's really a question for David or for Adam Booth to see if David will ever fight one of the Klitschko brothers.
I gotta ask you this. Why do everybody say, oh, I'm gonna kill Mayweather? Why do they all, like, yell that out? Like, they even have a shot.
As far as someone trying to fight Floyd?
Right now on the red carpet, puppeteers, whatever they were.
Well, I mean, they were saying that they would beat Klitschko, but, you know, Floyd's a great fighter. Floyd's really proven himself to be, you know, really one of the top pound-for-pound fighters in the world, and just amazing what he's done in the ring and taking his whole ability to a different level. He really dominates fighters in his you know, weight class, and he's done a great job with his career.
Him against Pacquiao?
Oh, that's a good one. Well, you know, I'd have to really. Manny is just so ferocious, and he comes out, but I don't really see anyone beating Floyd. You know, in that division, I don't see anyone beating Floyd.
I got you. Just working with the Klitschko brothers. Is there anything bigger than that, or is that like amazing?
Working with the Klitschko brothers. You know, it's funny. Now K2's promoted the most heavyweight championship fights in the last 10 years, and that's really an honor for me to be involved with them and with the company. And, you know, doing these big events, whether it's Madison Square Garden, whether it's Staples Center, whether it's these soccer stadiums in Germany. We did a fight in Switzerland. I mean, these are just mega events. These are worldwide events, similar to, you know, comparing it to the World Cup over in South Africa. I mean, these are huge events, even though they don't really happen here in the States. They're big international events. You get all these people, you get over 110 countries tuning in to broadcast the fight. So, I mean, it's really been an honor for me to work with both guys, and they're both consummate professionals. They both have their PhDs. I mean, I can't say enough as far as making my job easy to promote the events and to put everything together, because I don't have to worry about, you know, what the guys are doing. They're focused on their training, and they take care of their business inside the ring, so it allows myself and their manager, Byrne, to do everything outside the ring.
I've gotten to see Vladimir crack jokes, but a lot of people never get to see that side of the brothers, because we only see the workout machines. They're not even human. They're just in the gym 24/7. Yeah. Do you see their human side?
I love their human side. I mean, it's great working with them, whether it's in the gym or, you know, hanging out with them in a hotel or in the training camp. You know, you get to really see their sense of humor. Vladimir's got a great sense of humor when he did the whole thing with Borat at the sushi bar. And, I mean, that was really funny. But Vitaly's got a really good sense of humor, too, and he loves telling jokes. I mean, I can't remember a joke, but he can tell a joke in Russian, in German, and in English, and he's a really entertaining guy. And I love, you know, listening to both the guys. They're really good guys outside the ring as well as inside the ring.
Perfect.
Did I lose Michael?
Oh, he's done, I think. So last thing.
That's really okay. Good. That's right.
Yeah, I know. A lot of people are boxing fans. What's new with Jonathan Banks?
It's hard to focus on your questions, Elie, because we're here at the Playboy Mansion.
No.
it's hard to focus on the questions and concentrate on the answers with all these girls running back and forth at the Playboy Mansion. But Jonathan Banks, Jonathan is NABF champion. He's rated number 7 in the WBC, number 9 in the IBF. He's kind of following the footsteps of the brothers. He's really their main sparring partner, and he gets them in as far as in the ring, getting them ready for the fights. Jonathan will be on the show again in September, and we're really looking forward to him. His last performance wasn't so great because he had a shoulder injury, and we're looking forward to him, you know, taking his game up to the next level so he can really, when the brothers are done, then he'll kind of take the place of where they're at.
Perfect. Anything for Areola, for any of you guys?
For Areola?
Yeah, you want Vitaly rematch with Vlad.
I saw that Chris is fighting on ESPN against...
in August, yeah.
Yeah, I guess Goose and Tudor is going to do a show with Manuel Quezada, I think it is going to be. So it would be a good fight for Chris to come back with. I think Chris has all the talent in the world. The only thing is, and I know his trainer Henry really well, and it just, you know, if he got the conditioning part down and the dedication outside the ring down to match the talent that he has, I think Chris is a great fighter. I think he would beat most of his other guys. It's just a matter of, you know, him getting the focus outside the ring, and then that'll put everything together for him when he actually fights in the ring.
Thanks, Tom.
Okay.
Got it? All right, thanks. Have a great evening,
so
ladies.
What's the best part about being the bunny?
Good to see you.
What?
What's the best part about being the bunny?
Being able to come to the Playboy Mansion, of course.
Yes, and hop around.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
And the worst part?
And she's going to show you the hop now.
What's she going to show me?
Her hop.
I don't hop.
Just kidding.
Oh, her hop.
Yeah. Buddy hop.
What's your favorite sport?
Basketball.
Really? What's
basketball.
The team?
Snowboarders.
Snowboarding.
Is that a sport?
Derek Fisher signed today with the Lakers for 3 more years. What do you
Yay!
Say about that?
Yay! That's awesome. He's good.
Jordan Farmer left the team. He's going to New Jersey.
He did.
What do you say about that?
Oh. That's kind of disappointing. I liked him.
Aww.
Yeah. What else happened? Tell us.
Yeah,
happened?
I know.
Yeah, I've been on a plane all day. Tell me.
Well, Phil Jackson is back.
Well, he signed. I saw that. He re-signed.
So they're going to have a squad for the next 3 years. Ron Artest, Kobe Bryant, Howard Cosell, Derek Fisher.
Ron Artest is good, but I don't know, his attitude could still improve a little bit. Yeah.
So is it being here like the best thing? What would you tell people about just living the life?
Yeah, it's fun. I mean, we're so used to it.
I know, it's so normal. Like, yeah. You don't know any different, you know? We've been doing it for years, so it's like everyday life.
What were your names?
Tiffany Selby. I was Miss July 2007.
Stacy Fuson. I was Miss February.
So last question.
Just leave it at that.
Last question. Pacquiao or Mayweather? Because Hef is a big boxing fan.
Mayweather.
Mayweather?
You're not sure, huh?
I don't know. What did she say?
I went to the Mayweather fight a couple months ago.
Really?
Yeah.
Against
Vegas.
Sugar Shane Mosley. What did you make
yes.
of that fight?
It wasn't very exciting. I was hoping for a knockout or something exciting, yeah. It was just kind of like, huh? Oh, really? All right.
The highlight of the fight was the second round when Sugar Shane Mosley hit Mayweather and Mayweather's knees buckled.
Yeah. Yeah, that was good.
What do you think about the way Mayweather comes in the ring throwing money everywhere?
Yeah, I honestly didn't think it was going to go the full rounds, no. I was really surprised. And I missed the money thing. I didn't see that.
Well, thank you very much for the time.
You're welcome.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.